The swinging 60s was a turbulent decade of social change that also saw Louisville basketball solidify their perch as a perennial power. Louisville's own Cassius Clay captured gold in the 1960 Olympics before the controversial figure shook up the world, defeating Sonny Liston and changing his name to Muhammad Ali, still the greatest of all time. Regular season games now appeared on network radio and national TV on a regular basis, and John Tong settled in
for the thrill and excitement of college basketball,
beginning his 37-year legacy. Televisions lit up in color, bringing fans Gunsmoke and Bonanza, the Flintstones and the Jetsons, Star Trek and Batman.
Holy jackpot!
60 Minutes and Johnny Carson began his 30 years at the desk of The Tonight Show. After brief membership in the KIAC and one season in the OVC in the late 40s, the Cards officially joined the Missouri Valley Conference in 1963, when rules kept freshmen from playing on the varsity teams. The bestseller list saw the likes of To Kill a Mockingbird, Catch 22, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, and Where the Wild Things Are. In an era of social change that included Martin Luther King Jr.'s I Have a Dream speech and the groundbreaking Civil Rights Act of 1964, Wade Houston, Eddie Whitehead, and Sam Smith played on John Dromo's freshman team, breaking the color barrier at U of L in 1962. The decade took a horrific turn in 1963 with the assassination of President John F. Kennedy in Dallas. A nation and a world mourned. Wesley Unseld followed back-to-back state titles at Seneca High School by announcing his arrival at U of L in a scrimmage that pitted his freshman team against the varsity. His 33 points and 22 rebounds led the Frosh to the win.
Doesn't look like a freshman.
Cinema enticed viewers with shows like West Side Story, Mary Poppins, Sound of Music, Planet of the Apes, Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid, and Dr. Zhivago. Not long after practices moved from Belknap to Crawford Gym, the legendary Peck Hickman concluded his extraordinary career of 23 seasons with an MVC title in 1967, 443 wins, and two national championships, falling just short of the triple crown of titles that he coveted. Music saw extraordinary influence and change with Bob Dylan, Jimi Hendrix, Simon and Garfunkel, and the Beach Boys. Motown was founded, and Chubby Checker introduced us to the twist on American Bandstand. But no single influence was greater than that of the Beatles.
Which one's the walrus?
John Dromo's head coaching tenure began in the fall of 67, with Unseld pouring in a school record 45 points to go with 29 rebounds in the opener. The world was introduced to cassettes and 8-tracks, AstroTurf, the handheld calculator, zip codes, the Easy Bake Oven, and the Etch-a-Sketch. 2,000 fans were turned away at Freedom Hall as over 18,000 watched the Cards top Wichita State for the MVC title. Since the dunk was outlawed that season in the NCAA, Marv Selvey scored two the hard way. His 70-footer is the longest shot in school history. Butch Beard's 27 points in his debut still stands as a school record. He and his fellow seniors finished their time in the red and black with a home record of 39-1. For the first time, cars were split into classes, and the Ford Mustang was put in a class by itself. Three All-Americans, three honored numbers, and six more 1,000-point scorers made history for the Cards in the 60s.
Ooh, they're good.
Unseld, who closed his career to an endless standing ovation in Freedom Hall, averaged over 20 points and nearly 19 rebounds per game. He has since had his number 31 retired, been inducted into the Naismith Basketball Hall of Fame, and named one of the 50 greatest players in NBA history. Some post-war baby boomers, now teenagers and young adults, displayed fashion that matched the social change and led counterculture movements with anti-war sentiments, many times linked with music, like Woodstock in 1969. This decade of turbulence saw a steady flight of success for the basketball Cardinals.
I'm feeling it to myself,